This video is proudly sponsored by whatiszs.com. ZS is coming. Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers out there, just wanted to show you this and discuss this little drama with the Hawaiian volcano, because what they're actually saying is that they're saying that the thing is coming from a tube, like a tube that has actually happened and everything, but this video actually proves that it's not. This, just before this thing happened, you can see that this is that bit of the sea that has been bubbling. And that bit of the sea that has been bubbling has been offshore quite a distance, but now the lava is finally coming up close to it. But the whole point is they're actually covering over the truth, or they haven't worked it out yet. And this volcanic eruption didn't happen from where the lava was coming into the sea, because this has been a couple of hundred meters offshore as the lava has been slowly decreasing that, because right up until the time of the explosion, and you can even see it bubbling underneath even more violently in each of the videos. You've only got to review all the videos of the lava, because I've watched every one. I've watched this with great enthusiasm while I've been crook. I know pretty much nearly every video that has come on in regard to this. The boats have been driving through the two sections of it. I don't know whether this was the small bubble or the big bubble of the still water in the sea, and anybody watching these videos on the Hawaiian volcanic eruption will know that they were a great deal of distance originally from the land. It's just that the lava has been building land. But you look at this. This is a volcanic eruption. This isn't like a little thing and everything like that. This is actually a full-on volcanic eruption. I strongly recommend everybody go to the link that I'm going to put the link into the video. It's the volcanic eruption starts. They cut to this scenario at 3:40 in the video, and I strongly recommend everybody go to that section of the video and watch this. You'll see that it's away from the land. This is not caused by the lava coming from the land. This is coming from under the sea. That bubbling water has been a fissure all along. This is the fissures. There were two fissures. As far as I'm concerned, there were two, maybe three, because there's been three bubbling events in the water, two small ones, one large one. And see, what they haven't declared, that the fissure, see, they've numbered all the other fissures. This should be numbered the next number along the line, because this is a volcanic eruption out of the fissure underground. It's been building up and been building up and been building up. Now, if you look at the earlier in the video, you'll notice that around fissure 8, it's spilling over. In other words, there's a mass of lava coming out of fissure number 8. And And this happens around the same time as that massive spillover at fissure number 8. And it's coming from the sea. It's been, they're saying, a new island. It's about 20 feet wide. Well, why is there a new island? Because lava's been coming up from fissure number or 23 or 24, whatever you want to bloody call it, because that's from a fissure. And I believe all these bubbling events in the sea are other fissures that have opened up in the sea. And they forget that volcanoes open up in the sea as well. But they're trying to tell everybody, no, 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 it's coming from the land. They're bullshitting you. They're covering up the truth. So if you were in Hawaii, beware of any still water just off the coast. So all those boats should, if they're still allowed to go back out there, which I doubt, but should be aware that these bubbling waters are fissures under the ground. And they are bubbling the water, but eventually I'd say the water, too much water got in and it spagged the dummy. And it's turned around and injured 23 people. But you can clearly see where my cursor is, and if I can get my cursor back on the page, that there is nowhere near the thing. That's at least, oh God, that's a good distance from the thing. That's why the boat was so close, because the boat thought it was safe. It'd been going through these bubbling events for days and days. Well, months actually, 2 months it's been going. And these boats have been driving past these events without any problem. So the boat owners had thought it was safe, not realising it was a fissure, because the government failed to do their duty and realise it was a fissure. Or the USGS failed to do their duties and declare that they were underwater fissures, because that would have kept people away from them, because if there's an underwater fissure, boats aren't going to drive directly over the top of an underwater fissure. So you've got to blame the USGS, because they're the ones at fault, because they didn't declare that these were fissures under the thing. Oh, it's just coming in, it's going underneath. Well, you think about it, when water touches lava, it solidifies. So the water, yeah, every time lavas touch water, it just solidifies and causes lays. You see the result, and you look at the lays compared to this. This is mud, there's dirt, there's everything in that thing, because that's coming up from the sea bottom. And it didn't take me long to work it out, because as soon as I heard it, like, I've been looking at that for 2 months and thinking there's going to be a volcanic eruption at sea. And lo and behold, I haven't said anything, because, well, one, I've been crook, but the thing is, it's sort of, I couldn't be sure about it, but I was pretty sure about it. And I'm not a volcanologist, but like, I'm pretty much an engineer, and I understand logistics and thermodynamics and things like that. Well, boiling water needs a source to boil it, so hence there was a fissure under the water. And I believe there are other fissures, and if you examine all the helicopter footages, you will see that there are underground fissures underneath the water just off there. And there were three. One has just gone off. I don't know whether it was the smaller one or the bigger one, but it has gone off, and it was a great distance from the shore originally. And but the USGS failed to recognize it. So the USGS here is the ones at fault, not the boat drivers, because if the boat drivers were told, well, there's an active fissure at that spot, I guarantee you the boat drivers wouldn't drive over the top of an active fissure just in case. So what, lo and behold, what has happened? The USGS failure has cost 23 people, one seriously, to be injured. And I know this is off the subject of what I normally talk about, but I've got to comment on this, because this is a joke. They're blaming the boat driver. Yeah, the boat driver maybe shouldn't have gone as close, but if he was better informed, I guarantee you he wouldn't have gone over the top of an active fissure, because that's what it is. You can see that the fact that that water is bubbling away. You look here over near where the lays is, where my cursor is. Where's the bubbling water there? There's no bubbling water there. But you go back through all the helicopter footage, and I'm sorry I didn't prep it a bit better. I'd have it all, I forgot, because it was all on the other computer that I was watching it on. And I've got to make the videos on this computer. But the thing is, it's sort of, that is a volcanic event. Now I'm going to play a couple of seconds of it. That's a volcanic event. Oh, we might see it. Okay, so that was 2 seconds. We've got 8 seconds. 1, 2. Yeah, there's another one there. There's another one further off. Oh, no, that's the same one there. That's it there. That's it there. Right there. So, pretty much, there is a volcanic event. And you can see that that water is actually bubbling even more than normal. You look around where the lays and where it's entering, it's not actually bubbling that much. And there are plenty of these things being out there and plenty of videos where you can go and look for yourself. Look at all the helicopter footage where they're flying over the lays. You look how far offshore these still water things, they even talk about them. The people talk about them, wondering what they are. But the USGS should have recognised that that was, well, they should from now on, because they've failed to recognise that as an active fissure. And now 23 people have been injured. And the wrong person is being blamed. This is the fault of the USGS for not recognising it. Yes, the boat is partly responsible. But I believe if he was properly informed that that was an active fissure, they would have gone nowhere near it. And because I can tell you now, if someone told me, oh, well, there's an active thing off there, you can go this far to the lava and everything like that. Well, he was sort of, I think, under the new one where they're allowed to go a certain distance closer, and he went there. But the problem is it put him right over the top of the active fissure under the water, which now has formed an island and is pretty much its own vent now, and or fissure, or whatever you want to bloody call it. But it was a volcanic eruption. You can tell the difference between the lays and the volcanic eruption. That was a volcanic eruption under the sea. And you look at all the other video footage of all undersea volcanoes going off, it's exactly the same. It's exactly the same. Lava rock, lightning. Lightning only happens during a volcanic eruption. Now, if that was just a little tube caused by the stuff coming on top underneath, that would, because there's no pressure behind it. You need the pressure. So you need the actual tube. And the tube is, well, number one, where you find diamonds. And the thing is, that tube, where the lava thing, that is what presses it. So the stuff flowing on the surface, there's no pressure behind that. So, and how do I know about lava tubes? Well, I've studied diamonds. Where diamonds come from, how they come up to the surface, i.e. volcanoes. That'd be a major diamond field. But yeah, it'll take many years to bloody find them. But the whole point is that lava tube where that just erupted, that was coming directly from Kilauea, the same as Fissure 8. Fissure 8 was more active. This became active because more than likely the water pressure caused the eruption. Too much water got in and caused the eruption, because even they have said if water gets in there, that can cause a volcanic eruption. So the volcanic eruption happened because water, the pressure, bang, 23 people injured, USGS, you're at fault. So that's my 2 cents. And guys, I'm sorry for the stream that I promised everybody the other day, but I wound up in hospital. So anyhow, I'm going to catch up to you all later. And yes, you'll notice I'm talking a little bit better. The speech therapy is working. Face still paralyzed, but yeah, it's working. And I'm still fighting the strike, by the way. So, but anyhow, guys and gals, I'm going to catch up to you later. But USGS is actually responsible for not recognizing. I think they knew, but they didn't want to say. And now they're covering their ass, saying it's coming from there, and that, oh yeah, well, this could have happened. But the thing is, they knew. I think in a way they knew it was a fissure, but they didn't want to acknowledge it because they couldn't see it. But the fact that boiling water under the sea, that tells you that it's a fissure. They knew about it a month ago, easy a month ago, maybe 2 months. So effectively, they are the ones at fault for not warning the people that there was an active fissure underneath the water. Anyhow, I'm out of here. I'm sick of shit when governments do this shit. So anyhow, guys and gals, I'm going to catch up to you all later. And hope to see you soon on the stream. So yeah, as I said in the last videos, if you want to watch my streams, you will have to go over to my backup channel, which I'm going to put the link into this video. If you want to go to the backup channel, it will be the second link. The first link will be the link to this video. And make your own minds up about this video. But if you want to watch my streams when I do start streaming in the next few days, I will put a notification out on the channel that I'm going to do a stream. But if you're not connected up to the other channel, you're not going to know about it unless you watch the video. So, and yeah, if you're one of the guys that come over and watch me stream and everything like that, I strongly recommend that you go over to my backup channel, sign up. And so I'm going to catch up to you all later. And yes, USGS, you are the ones at fault here, not the boat driver. You should have warned the boat driver not to go over those patches, because of the, even if you had said there's a possibility of a fissure underneath, because today the proof of the pudding has happened. 23 people now injured.